Hello, everybody. Well, I'm not done yet. I've got unfinished business, and I'm not letting it sit until I get what I'm looking for. I've got a 3-day weekend, and I'm going to Florida again. I'm not just going anywhere in Florida. I'm going to Apalachicola National Forest. This is a very well-known place to go herping, and guess what they've got there? You guessed it, eastern diamondback rattlesnakes. Of course, as with every Florida trip I've taken, that's the main target. I have yet to be successful with this goal, but I think just maybe this might be it. So without further ado, I'm gonna finish this long drive I've got ahead of me, and we're going to have an amazing adventure. So y'all stay tuned.
It's beautiful, it's bittersweet, you're like a broken home to me. I take a shot of memories in black, I like an empty street. I fill my days with the way you walk and fill my nights with broken dreams. I make up lies inside my head like one day you'll come back to me. Now I'm not holding on, not holding on, I'm just depressed that you're gone.
So I made it. I'm here. I'm at Apalachicola National Forest. Now, usually what I would do is I would cut the video here and I would pick up with tomorrow morning, but the majority of what I'm going to be doing this trip is road cruising, okay? And I've still got 15 miles until my campsite that goes straight through the National Forest, so I could end up seeing some really cool stuff just on the way to my campsite. It's a little late, but there's still the chance that it could happen. Let's see what ANF has in store for me. So I'm driving to my campsite, and I'm hearing a lot of different frog species on the way there, and I don't know if y'all hear that little click click noise. That's something called a little grass frog, and I have never seen one before, and I really, really want to. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over there and see if maybe I can spot one. There's one like right in here. I can't see it though. Oh, I see it. I see it. I see it. I see it. Oh my god, it's a little grass frog. Look at that. And they're tiny. I'm gonna grab this one and bring him out to show y'all closer. That is so cool. Okay, so I got him in my hand, and I'm gonna just set him down in the road for a second to like show y'all it, because it's a really just absolutely minute species of frog. I'm gonna see if I can put my hand next to it just to give y'all an idea of truly how small he is. This is my fingertip, and y'all can see that, right? Like, that is an absolutely just tiny, tiny frog. They're here in Florida, but we do not, oh, look at him walk. That is so cool. I mean, this is about as big as they get from what I've heard, and they are just absolutely precious. Look at him. Isn't that precious? Oh, there he goes. He's climbing onto my finger. Oh, that's so precious. Oh my goodness. He just leaped. Oh, he's on my leg now. Wow. That was so cool. Okay, I'm gonna let this guy go. Oh. That's amazing. Okay. We got more amphibians. There's something calling in here. I think they're pine woods tree frogs, but I'm not sure. I want to look. They're like right in here somewhere. It's right in this area. I just can't see it. Oh, I see it. I see it. They're right. Let's see what this is. It's either a pine woods tree frog or a squirrel tree frog. Oh my god, it's a pine woods. It's a pine woods tree frog. Once again, another lifer for me. Oh, whoa. Got him, got him. I found the other one. It's this thing right here. What? Oh, look, look, look. It's a squirrel tree frog. That's what's making that noise. Look, see him? He's right there. That is so cool. And then this one right here, I believe is a female. Right there. Wow. This is awesome. Let's see if maybe I can just, oh, got him. All right, let's take a look at him here. Oh, okay. So this one right here is a pine woods tree frog. I've never seen one of these before. This is a lifer for me. And then this one right here is a squirrel tree frog. I've seen them before, so this isn't a lifer, but they look very similar to green tree frogs, except the stripe on their labial portion isn't solid white, and it's not as prominent. It's more of a yellow color. Plus, as you can hear, their call sounds very different from a green tree frog. But yeah, here's the pine woods tree frog. They're just completely different altogether. That's amazing. There they go. Well, I think I just found a carpenter frog. Is that what this is? I think that's a carpenter frog. I could be wrong, but it looks like a carpenter frog to me.
So it turns out this was actually not a carpenter frog. I got all excited being in Florida thinking it might be something different from what I'm used to, but it was actually just a bronze frog just like we get back home in Tennessee. So the carpenter frog, I'll just have to save that for my next trip.
Wow, if that's a carpenter frog, that would also be a new species for me. That's really cool. I'm gonna go ahead and help him, oh bud, come on. No, he doesn't want to go. Okay. Let me just pick you up then and assist you across the road. He's alive. He hasn't been hit. He's just being stubborn. Funny. There you go. You got a southern toad. That's another one I don't see very often, but that's actually not what I'm interested in right now. I am hearing a different species of toad off into the wilderness over here that interests me a lot more, and that's an eastern spadefoot. Y'all can hear that in there. A bow, bow, bow noise. I see one in the middle right there. That's an eastern spadefoot toad. No, it's two of them. Lunan plexus. Right there. There's another one. There they go. There's a bunch of them in here. Look at those guys. Two right there. Eastern spadefoot toads. God. The amphibians are just loving it tonight. So the thing that's so cool about eastern spadefoot toads is that they're a species of toad that only come out and breed after absolute downpour conditions. So the fact that these toads are out calling right now here tells me that the rain has been very extreme leading up to my visit here, which could, in some instance, work to my advantage. So that's really, really cool. There's some frog making a really high-pitched squeaking noise, and I'm trying to find it, but I can't pinpoint one. And I quite honestly don't know what it is. Oh, that's what it is! It's an oak toad! No way! Look, I see it! There's two of them! They're in plexus! Oh, no way! That's the coolest thing, dude! They're oak toads! Oh my god, that is so cool. I've never seen one of these before. And there's two of them in plexus right there. Like, is that not the coolest thing?
So that's what that high-pitched one was. I was trying to, you know, because I knew I had heard that before, but I just couldn't put my finger on what it was. And now it all makes sense. It's an oak toad. Another lifer. I've never seen one of those before.
We are. This is where I'm camping. Made it. Let's get this adventure going.
Music. Another one. DJ Khaled.
Stayed down till I came up. I did it, I did it, I did it. Ten toes and never changed up. I did it, I did it, I did it. Got my hands in the air right now, cause I just wanna be here right now. I did it,
I did it,
I did it.
I did it.
this trip is predominantly going to consist of road cruising. Now, road cruising is not going to be the only thing I do, but most of what I'm going to be doing here is road cruising. So, right now, I'm headed down to the south end of the park, and going on a road that I've been told has a lot of diamondbacks, a lot of pine snakes, you know, you name it. It's got a bunch of really awesome stuff on it, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see, but I'm really happy to be back here in Florida.
Stayed down till I came up.
Okay, I have been out here cruising for hours and haven't gotten a single snake until now. I don't know if y'all can see it in the rear view mirror right there. It's a, there we go, a racer. He's right there, and you know, I usually don't get too terribly excited about racers, but the species that lives out here is something called a brown chin racer, and that would be a lifer for me, so I'm gonna see if I can catch this snake. He may dart off, but I'm gonna try to get him. I'm gonna really try. Alright, he's right there. I'll slowly sneak up to him. Got him, got him, got him. I got him. Oh, let's bring him out onto the road. Hi. Hi. Yep, I know. I see you. Oh! Hey! Ouch! Let's be nice, okay? Yay, 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 yay. Well, honestly, ah! Honestly, he quite looks just like a normal racer, like a black racer to me. I mean, I don't know. Maybe I'm just crazy. I don't know. Well, first snake though, that's good. I was getting concerned that I wouldn't find any snakes out here today, but, oh my god, did you see him just launch himself at me like that? Jesus, classic racer for ya. Whew. Yeah, he is just at it right now. He is just at it. Bing. Ooh. Yes, I know. I know. Is it a brown chin or is it a southern black? I think it's a brown chin. I mean, it's kind of got a little bit of brown on its head there. I mean...
So this time I was correct. This was, in fact, a brown chin racer. Its chin wasn't as brown as I was expecting it to be, but I asked some people and it, sure enough, is a brown chin racer. So how about that? A new snake.
I guess you would consider that a brown chin racer. Well, alright, we got our first snake. I mean, it's not anything, like, super legendary, but... Either way, still, I'm happy that I'm finally starting to find snakes now, because I was really getting worried that I wouldn't find anything for, you know, that first little bit, because I was having bad luck, but maybe this is a good sign that stuff will start popping up. I know. All right, I'm gonna let him go.
All right, this guy is so eager to go, so I'm just gonna let him do his thing.
Well, how about that? First live snake of the trip. Hopefully the first of many. Let's go. Oh my gosh, the cruising is finally starting to produce, and I just got something really awesome that I was really hoping to get. Oh, it's a pygmy. Oh, hi there, friend. Oh, it's a dusky pygmy rattlesnake. Look at that. Whoa, 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 wait, 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 wait. Let me get my hook. That'll make life quite a bit easier. Yes, I got a pygmy, yes. That was a bit of a nightmare. So, this isn't the rattlesnake that I was out here, like, mainly targeting, but, whoo! This is another rattlesnake that I really wanted to see. This is a dusky pygmy rattlesnake. They're the smallest species of rattlesnake in the world, and here they are, right in Florida, and they are just absolutely awesome. Oh my goodness. Look at that. So, the dusky pygmy rattlesnake is a subspecies of pygmy rattlesnake that I've never seen before. I've seen western pygmy rattlesnakes. Those are the ones that we get in Tennessee. I haven't seen one in Tennessee yet, but that's definitely on the bucket list. Now, this I have never seen before. This is the southernmost subspecies of the pygmy rattlesnake. And you know, they're just like the other ones. They're absolutely tiny, all right? When a baby is born, they can coil up within the diameter of a half dollar. That is how small they are, and they really don't ever get too terribly large after that. This is actually an adult snake, okay? He's probably not ever gonna get a whole lot bigger than this. I mean, he may get a little bit bigger, up to possibly 2 feet, but that would be a monstrously huge pygmy rattlesnake.
But they're a very common pit viper that you get out in Florida. I just haven't been lucky enough to see one until now, and I can't tell you how happy I am that I actually ended up getting to see one. The first live venomous snake of the trip, and you can see up by his tail, you know, they're called a rattlesnake, and they are a true rattlesnake. They do have a rattle, but it's absolutely tiny. And a lot of the times when people hear them rattle, they mistake it for like a bug or like a cicada or something like that. Maybe not even a cicada, just a little itty bitty buzzing bug, because, you know, their rattle hardly makes any noise at all unless you put your face like right up next to it, which obviously I don't ever recommend you do. But they're just absolutely awesome snakes. I'm so happy I got to see one. This was definitely one of the things I was hoping to see while I was out here, so I'm super happy stuff is starting to pick up. All right, bud, I'm gonna go ahead and let him back go across the road where he was going, and maybe we'll get your much larger cousin on the road here soon. All right, bud, I'm gonna help scoot this guy back across the road where he was going. Here you go, my friend, you're free to go. Free to go, bud. Well, he's being all standoffish and stuff. There you go, you're free to go, buddy, come on. That's okay. I'll just let him do his thing. Dusky pygmy rattlesnake, how about that? Let's keep going.
Good lord, the snakes are out now. I just straddled another pygmy.
Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Look, look, look. That's another one, dude. This is the second pygmy rattlesnake of the... Oh, listen, listen. Listen, you can hear that. So he actually has a slightly larger rattle than the last one. And when he twitches his rattle around like that, you can actually hear it quite a bit more than the last one. How awesome is that? That is just awesome. This is the second pygmy of the day. Once again, super duper small snake, but absolutely gorgeous. And they are just so aware. They do the head bobbing. They do the twitching of the rattle. Ooh, there he is. That is just absolutely amazing. Luckily, the bites from these typically are not very bad. I don't think I've ever heard of anyone actually dying from a pygmy rattlesnake bite. Nonetheless, you don't want to get bit by one, but it's not that bad if you do get bitten. Just go to a hospital and they'll take care of you. But they're kind of like copperheads almost with their venom toxicity. Gosh, the second one. Oh my gosh. Well, dude, today's actually turning out to be good. Well, this has gone like a full 180 really, really fast. Well, I'm gonna get him off the road and keep going, because, I mean, geez, snakes are coming out, dude. I mean, they were really slow for a minute there, but now they're coming out, so let's keep going. All right, buddy. Time to get you off the road. He is just beautiful, isn't he? Dude, ah, this is awesome. I'm having a blast out here. Let's find more.
So I can't seem to beat the rain. It won't stop coming. I've tried to drive away from it and avoid it, but it just keeps coming, and it's here to stay. From what I've heard, Eastern Diamondbacks don't like rain. Two brown chin racers, one of which y'all didn't see because it got away, and two pygmy rattlesnakes the first morning. I mean, I won't complain about that. Let's hope that it only gets better from here.
House gecko, there's three house geckos. More house geckos, goodness. Holy crap, look at all those crabs.
Here I find myself on these islands once again. This isn't the same island as I was on earlier this year, it's a different one, but I found myself going in this direction, so I thought I might as well stop and take a look, because there are diamondbacks out in this area, and I actually talked to one of the park rangers, and he said that the area I'm in right now, you know, they've been sighted here a decent amount of times, so I'm kind of just gonna do the same thing I did a few months ago, and we'll just have to wait and see. So basically what I'm doing, since it's so blazing hot out right now, is I'm going to shaded areas, kind of like, you know, kind of like this,
I'm looking around in these shaded areas because, you know, that should be where the diamondbacks would go when it's really hot. They'd be coiled up at the base of these, you know, bushes and stuff like that. Potentially even a gopher tortoise burrow, I don't know. But, you know, it is still possible to find them in these hot times. It's just a lot harder, so. Ah, yes. That's the kind of sign I like to see. I'm curious if there actually are alligators out here, though. Tell me this is an absolutely incredible eastern diamondback habitat. Yet, I cannot find any eastern diamondbacks. I'm hot, I'm gonna go for a swim.
Just kind of trying to find a way to kill time during the heat of the day because there's really not a whole lot that you can find when it's that blazing hot. The evening is slowly but surely encroaching upon us, so after I get some dinner, I'm gonna get back out on the road and see what I can get. I think tonight's gonna be good.
Great, it's fantastic.
Alright, so we're back to road cruising. I'm gonna be cruising this road for a few hours. I'm hoping to see, obviously, my main goal is an eastern diamondback, but there's a lot of other things that I'm also hoping to see. I think some good stuff will pop up, so let's see what we get. I know it's just for a second.
And just like that, we've got our first snake. We have our first non-pygmy rattlesnake snake. No way! No way! Yes! Ow, he bit me!